Hey guys! No, that's lame.
Well, it's okay, you're lame.
Welcome back to the 30 Day Pixar. What? No! It's finals week. My brain's fried. Let's try that again. Welcome back to the 30 Day Disney Challenge, which is a challenge created by Tumblr user Colorful Cotton. We are on day 20, which means we have 10 more days to go. Today's challenge is your favorite sequel. Mine probably comes as not a surprise to anybody who's been watching this journey. It is The Lion King 2, which I absolutely loved as a kid, absolutely loved it. I got the movie for my birthday when I was in, I think, 7th or 8th grade. I loved the movie. I remember playing this little interactive game with Kiara chasing butterflies. I loved that. It's just a really great movie, and then I grew up having the biggest crush on Kovu, and I am a furry.
No surprise here, but it is Aladdin 3, the Aladdin and the King of Thieves. I grew up watching Aladdin a lot. I grew up watching Return of Jafar. I watched the show, so obviously I like the third movie. It's not as good as the first one, but it's very good. I like it a lot. I especially like Aladdin's dad. He's pretty hot, and he's voiced by Gimli from Lord of the Rings. There's your little trivia fact. Or if you prefer, he's that crap guy from Aquaman. Oh, and Robin Williams came back. That's good too.
And Genie has like the best song ever. All right, let us know what your favorite Disney sequel is down in the comment section below, or I guess Pixar sequel. I am curious what your answer is, because the Disney sequels unfortunately get kind of a bad reputation. They're not all that bad, so we're just curious. Let us know which one you like.
As long as it's not Milo's Return, that one sucks.
Oh, I was gonna say The Hunchback.
Oh yeah, that one too.
If that's what your answer is, please just don't.
I refuse to watch that one.
I may lose respect for you.
Mulan 2 is pretty bad too. That one's.
I haven't seen that.
The rest of them are okay. Tarzan 2 was.
Pocahontas 2 is not that bad.
Yeah, Pocahontas 2 might actually be a little better than the original, honestly. It makes Ratcliffe actually a good villain, and also ends with him being executed, which is great.
Totally awful the way they dealt with John Smith, but.
Oh,
it's not that bad of a movie. It's pretty good. The racism message is pretty good.
I wouldn't want to be with Mel Gibson either, so I think they did the right thing.
We'll see you guys tomorrow, hopefully. Fingers crossed for day 21. Bye, everybody.